And Secretary of State Rex Tillerson is returning from Asia on a diplomatic assignment, much of it focused on corralling international responses to North Korea. While the Secretary of State was returning, North Korea responded specifically to the language of the president in which he said North Korea would be brought down upon fire and fury. The North Korean People's Army says of President Trump that sound dialogue is not possible with him as he is bereft of reason. The statement also says that only absolute force can work on the president. North Korea also says it's seriously examining a plan to envelop Guam with 4 missiles around the island. Secretary Tillerson's message is that Americans should sleep well and have no concern about the rhetoric of the past few days. It's a much different tone than the president's fire and fury comments, and that's drawing questions to the State Department about consistency.
As people look at this, and some consider comments to have been alarming, I would have to go back to this. Let's consider what is alarming. What is alarming? 2 ICBM tests in less than a month, 2 nuclear tests that took place last year.
Secretary Tillerson is pushing what the administration calls a pressure campaign to get other countries to economically, diplomatically isolate North Korea, try to rob it of its financing. Included in that is stronger enforcement of existing sanctions and the sanctions that the UN Security Council passed just this past weekend. John?
Rich Edson at the State Department. Thank you, Rich.